Hello and welcome. I am Sahanamra Singha. This is our Comparatively Integrated Systems module assignment 2, XML, RPC and RMI distributed recycling machine. I am Sahanamra Singha. My Bedwetsaya University ID is 1624742. My partner is Rasika Lakshan Jayaratna. His UOB ID is 1622814. So here we will be explaining about the interface we have designed for using RMI version. So let's go and have a look. In this project, I did the client side and Rasika did the server side. Other than that, I also did the documentation part with the support of Rasika. So let's open the Eclipse and let's go through the video. So actually we are using two our personal laptops. This one belongs to me and this is Rasika's laptop. So let's check whether we have the two laptops are connected to each other. So Rasika's machine IP is 192.168.43.225. So it's connected. You can see this is his laptop's IP.
Now let's run the server.
Yeah, first of all we have to run the server in order to work the recycling machine. So let's run it from the server, headquarters server.
First, the server will ask to admin credentials. If the password, username password is correct, then he can log into the server. Now, server is automatically started. Now, let's.
So now we can use the recycle machine. So this is the client side Colombo. This is the recycle machine. So I will run it. So here you can see by default the recycle machine is inactive. So the user has to connect with the headquarters server in order to get this machine activated. So let's enter the destination server's IP address and the port number. So engineer has to give these credentials in order to connect with the headquarters server. So the destination IP would be the Lakshan's laptop IP address and the port number. So by default we have given the port number as 1100. You can see the login attempt is successful. And as soon as it gets successful, the machine will be activated. Now the recycle machine is online. So the same time you can monitor, if you go to the server, it will show the IP address and the host name.
Sahan's IP address and the host name here.
So let's verify it. If you go to command prompt and check the host name, you can see my computer IP name is 7PC, so that also will be picked to the server. So now the machine is active, so let's add couple of items and see how it is working actually. So I'm gonna add a couple of items. Then after I have to before that actually we can
once the client enter items, it will automatically create these logins at one by one. Finally, this will show the current item values that get from this IP.
So as soon as I enter item, it will be the record will be saved in the destination server. So let's print the receipt and see. So you can see the item values will be printed in the GUI, and so once I print the receipt, also the summary of items can be visible through the, via the server also. So let's go to Rasika's computer and see how it is working. So you can see a new window will be prompted, and you can see the.
So when we select this IP and view summary, it will show the in the pie chart.
And what are the machines usage based on the values and the items. So that is working as well. So now the site engineer part is there. So whenever site engineer visit to a remote located recycling machine, so he should be able to log into the recycling machine using his own credentials, log into the system. So let's see how it works. So let's assume that I'm the engineer, site visiting engineer. So I just have to click on the settings, and I have to give my credentials, which has been given by the server. Actually, the credentials are engineer. It will prompt a message if you enter the wrong credentials. It will say that the credentials are wrong. Also, so this login, everything is connected with the database, phpMyAdmin. So let's go and have a look what are the correct credentials. So here you can see we can use a particular login. Let's use ENG login. So the credential should be ENG, and the password
123.
Should be 123. There you go, you can see the login is successful now. So now site engineer can do these things, like he can reset cans, reset bottles, reset crates, update values, reset paper bags, and finally he can empty the full machine. So let's do it now. So as soon as I select this particular option, so this can be visible in the server side. So let's try it. So I want to, let's assume I want to reset cans because the items are full in the machine. So let's reset it. It will confirm that the transaction has been updated. So as soon as it is updated, you will be able to see it on the headquarters server also.
So let's go to engineer visits and see what the client PC does. See, the client is reset the can. Then log is successfully entered here.
So that's how it will work. So let's try another sample also. Let's try to reset the bottles and try to reset cans. So let's see whether it has been recorded in.
Okay, you can see that records are successfully logged here.
So the site engineer visiting part also completed. So also there is an option to change the item values from the headquarters server. So let's go and see how it works practically.
Okay, in here that we can change the individual items value. So let's try to change one. 9.
By default, as of now, can value is 10. So now, as a sample, we have changed the value of cans to 9.
Now the site engineer has to update the values. Until he update the values, this
values
won't
change
be
won't get
unchanged.
applied. So site engineer has to click on the update values button. So it will prompt a message saying successful. So let's print it. Actually the machine is empty at the moment. So now let's see whether the changes has been made successfully applied. Here we go, you can see now the new CAN value is 9, so it is working perfectly. So like that, engineer can change the values of the item. So now let's see what are the other things we can do using the headquarters server.
Here we can register new engineer and also we can new administrator. Let's see. Test engineer 1 2 3 4 password account types engineer. You can see engineer successful enter. Let's see the database and check whether it's successfully updated. You can see the test engineer successfully updated. Now we can also log in through these credentials. And we can also see the okay, now we can see the most used machine by click this and refresh. All the these items get from the database. Let's see and go see to see the database. Each time the client, when the client add items, it will count here. And you can see the Sahan's IP address here and the host name here. Okay, now check if it is correctly updated. Go to again client PC and add some item and let's see, this will this should be 80 and whatever the item also should increase.
So now let's add the sample item. We will add one bottle and we will print the receipt. So now let's move to the server and see whether the database has been updated or not.
Currently it is
79. Here we go. Okay. You can see the values has been added, so which means the database connectivity is working perfectly fine. So now let's move to the server and see the other so-called function which is we can see the mostly used items in the server interface.
So in here that we can see the most used machine. So you can see the this machine is updated. Now it is the most used item, most used machine. So it should shown as 80. Okay, thank
so,
you.
So yeah, so that's all about the demonstration of the video site. So now let's go and have a look at the source codes of the programs and let's talk about how we have achieved those things in next video.